वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स कंटिन्यू अवर चैप्टर 9, राइट, ऑफ जियो. वी हैव कंप्लीटेड टिल रेमेडीज फॉर फॉरेस्ट कंजर्वेशन. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट ऑन पेज नंबर 68, चैप्टर 9, पेज नंबर 68, वाइल्ड लाइफ डाइवर्सिटी. सो अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज व्हाट? चैप्टर 9, वाइल्ड लाइफ डाइवर्सिटी. नाउ व्हाट इज डाइवर्सिटी? लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज डाइवर्सिटी. डाइवर्सिटी मीन्स अ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ स्पीसीज दैट इज फाउंड. लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन इंडिया यू विल हैव यू नो डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ स्पीसीज. लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी हैव बर्ड्स, वी हैव एनिमल्स, वी हैव मैमल्स, वी हैव रेप्टाइल्स, वी हैव एक्वाटिक एनिमल्स, right? Different types of microorganism. So here we are going to discuss about wildlife diversity. So what, how much our India is diversified in a wildlife? So that what we are going to discuss in this chapter. So on page number 68, wildlife diversity. Now another reason why we have a diversity, the reason is a physiography. Physiography means what? Physiography means we have a different type of climatic condition. We have different type of relief features. Right? So these all are the reason we have a different types of diversity in wildlife. So there is a large diversity in climate and physiography in India. Right? Due to this geographical diversity, a large variation is seen among the insect, birds, animals, and vegetation. Means, like for example, when we talk about a geographical diversity, you'll find yak in mountainous region, right? You will find camel in a desert region, right? So why a yak is found in a mountainous region only? What are the reasons you will find camel in a desert region? Why? Because of the climatic condition, because of the relief features, and because of their adaptation also. How they have adapted. This also plays a very important role. Maybe you have, you know, already done in science also. So, birds, animals and vegetation, right? There are about 15 lakh species in the world. How much? 15 lakh in world. We have a different type of species. 15 lakh in world. Now from that, 81,251 species are found in India. So how much in India we'll find species? We are talking about species in our country. So 81,251 species are found in India. India stands 12th in the world in terms of biodiversity. So what is our rank? So we are on a 12th rank in a biodiversity. Right? So we are on biodiversity. Animals from Asia, Europe, and Africa are seen in India. Right? Like for example, African Zarak, European wolf, wild goats, and Kashmiri deer, elephants and gibbons from Southeast Asia, etc. are found here. The biodiversity of India includes black bear, one horned rhino, deer, different types of snakes, peacock, goroid, hawk, kingfisher, flamingo. These are the very, you know, important part of our biodiversity. These animals are which are found in our country. Currently, India is the only country in the world where the tiger and lion are seen moving in the natural. bachelor course. Like for example, there is no other country in the world where you will find lion also and tiger also. Now, Asiatic lion in the whole world are found in our country only, in Gujarat, in Gir. So that is what beauty of our wildlife diversity, right? So the snow leopard in Himalayas and the red panda found are the same altitude, are distinguished animals here. Currently, India is the only country in the world where tiger and lion are seen moving in the natural abodes. During winter, migratory birds from distant places throng into the watershed area of Keoladev National Park, Bharatpur and Nal Sarovar in Gujarat to spend winter. Means they come from, you know, thousands and, you know, millions of miles away from, they come to India to stay in our country, to, you know, lay eggs, to grow their, lay their eggs. Why? Because this climatic condition is favorable for them. So most probably you will find in Keoladev, in Bharatpur and Nal Sarovar. These are the region where you'll find okay, every year lakhs of the migratory birds come to India and they stay here in a winter. So this is what the wildlife diversity beauty is there. Sea turtles come to lay eggs along the sandy coast of Odisha. Indian python, various snakes and the king cobra are found in the southern rain forest. Right? So this is what is wildlife diversity is. Right? Now with wildlife diversity, there is one more thing is also there. There is a danger on wildlife. Right? Now when we talk about danger in wildlife, so because of danger on wildlife, we have seen that many animals, many birds, many insects, many aquatic animals, they all started, you know, on the verge of extinction. Some are already extincted. So that what we are going to discuss, that is a wildlife extinction. Extinction means what? You will find nowhere in the on the earth such species which are in our, means which are on earth before some years. So now we don't have any such species. So this is what the extinction means. Or some animals are on the verge of extinction. Extinction matlab verge of extinction matlab khatam nahi hua hai. Lekin itne kam hai ke shayad in next 20 or 40 years or 50 years you will not find such animals on the earth, right? So that is a verge on the verge of extinction, right? So wildlife on extinction on page number 68 only. Today many wild animals in the world are on the verge of extinction. Tigers were found throughout India during last century. Means all over India you will find tiger. Lakhs of tigers are there when colonies started. Right? 200 years ago, agar hum baat kare, to there were lakhs of tigers are there in every region you will find. Tigers were seen in the forest of Edam, Ambaji and Danta. Today, tigers are totally extinct from Gujarat forest area. Not a single tiger will found in a forest region of Gujarat. Cheetah is also extincting from Indian forest. Right? Not a single cheetah is there. You will find cheetah in African forest, but not a single cheetah is there in our India. So they are on the verge of extinction or completely extincted from the Indian forest, not from the world on the earth. Many bird species which were very easily seen in Indian forest are now hardly seen. Means many birds are there, many animals are there. Now the such species are, you cannot see anywhere in our country. Now, for example, agar hum baat kare, you can ask your parents. There were many sparrows around us and when we, you know, we were small, of your age. So, now you cannot see sparrow anywhere. So, what is the reason? Maybe they are extincted. Maybe they are not found. Why they are not around us? So, there are many reasons why they are not around us. Some of them like vultures, duck and pink throat cranes and owls are on the verge of extinction. Chitralotro bird, once widespread in Arunachal Pradesh of northeast, is not seen so easily. Chitralotro aisa bird tha ki aap agar northeast Arunachal Pradesh ja rahe to aapko har jagah dikhega. Now you cannot see Chitralotro bird. So they are on the verge of extinction. There is a danger of survival to the alligators of the freshwater of rivers and Ganga River dolphin. Ganga River dolphin also you will not find. Otherwise, though, you will find dolphin everywhere in the Ganga River. Now you cannot find, right? You have to go very far, then only you can find some dolphins. The numbers of sea turtles approaching the coast of Odisha and Gujarat is constantly decreasing. For many years, you know, turtles are not coming to Odisha. They come from the, all the way they come, they swim under the sea and they come on the coast of Odisha. This year, we have seen, turtles coming to Odisha. Why? Because of this lockdown and all. Waterfowls, jalbilari se kaha jata hai. Once found frequently in Narmada, Tapi, Mahi and Sabarmati rivers of Gujarat, is almost extinct. There were many jalbilari we have seen in Kakaria and in the zoo. Now we cannot see a single waterfowl in this region. Why? They are extincted. So a time has come for us to think about this seriously. So we have to think many things, we have to think about it. Means we have to think very seriously. Okay, why? What are the reasons? What is the role of humans? What is the role of humans in the, to disturb the nature? How we are disturbing ecosystem? How we are disturbing animals? So that would we have to think about it. So this is what about the wildlife extinction, right? Now, we have discussed about wildlife extinction. Now what we are going to discuss on page number 69, reasons for the destruction of wildlife. Means why wildlife are, what are the reasons, what we are doing. That what I told you earlier also. Okay, now we have to think about it. Okay, what are the reasons and what we are doing and what is the role of humans to create such situation where these animals are on the verge of extinction. So that what we are going to discuss in our next topic. Right? So our next topic is what? Reasons for the destruction of wildlife. So reasons for the destruction of wildlife. Right? Now we are going to discuss this thoroughly. What are the reasons for the destruction of wildlife?